Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Our guest today for the Women in Leadership series is Siham Malek. She is a seasoned expert in African markets, brings over 20 years of experience to her role as managing director at Integrate. She's a thought leader championing ethical insights and data analytics, known for driving brand growth through data-driven strategies. Siham's leadership extends to her role in expanding the Brand Africa initiative and chairing the brand creation and marketing chapter of the G100 Wings. Let's go and talk to Siham. Hi, Siham. How are you?
Hi, Amra. I'm doing well. How are you?
I'm good. Thank you so much for being here today.
I'm so happy to be here with you, Amra, today.
Siham, please share some experiences that led you to become a thought leader in the field of market research and data analytics in Africa. You're actually from Morocco, right?
Exactly. I am from Morocco and I've been working on the market research, insight and data analytics field for the last two decades. And there is one constant throughout my 20 years of experience is that unfortunately, the decision makers don't realize the importance of market research in their business. They don't see how much a good insight and a good consumer understanding and a good market research can change their business. And especially after COVID, when COVID hit, and you know, as you may know, the inflation, all the issues, all the economical issues we're living, so many businesses, even the biggest ones, have started, you know, cutting budgets. And one of the main budgets that are cut are market research budgets. And when we cut market research budgets, we are actually putting a barrier in front of us instead of, because when we're having issues, we're having economical issues, when we are not selling as much as we're supposed to, when we are not reaching the consumers as much as we're supposed to, we need market research actually. So what's happening is the opposite of what is supposed to happen.
Right.
So I've taken it as a purpose to educate the market, educate Morocco first, but the whole Africa and the world, why not? On the importance of market research, not only for big companies, but also for small companies and startups. So since that, it's been like now a year and a half, I am fully involved in the market research society. Mm-hmm. I am the president of the Market Research Association in my country, and I work with other associations throughout Africa and throughout the world. I have developed, I myself have a show, a LinkedIn Live that I do. I try to keep it as much as twice a month. I didn't do it for the last month because it was vacation. And then, as you know, we were hit by an earthquake in Morocco.
Yes, yes.
So I do a live show, which is called Data is the New Oil, to basically talk about the importance of market research, the different types of market research, when to do market research. And I also invite experts from different domains to talk about how important is market research to their work and how we can, for example, use AI in market research, what is the impact of AI on market research and data analytics.
Excellent.
But that's not only my only thing I do. That's one thing, which is market research. I'm also a very a strong believer in brands. To me, the brand to any company is the most precious asset a company has. So for me, the market research is just a part of, or you know, market research is actually the enabler to make informed decisions to build brands. I encourage companies to build brands and not just to sell products, because branding to me is very essential. And for that, I got involved in the Brand Africa initiative, which was launched like 11 years ago in South Africa, and we've launched it in North Africa in the last 4 years. And actually, this is an initiative to encourage brands or encourage local companies to build brands. Of course, based on informed decisions, based on insights, based on a consumer-centric way of thinking.
Great, wonderful. So you're also a country chair of the brand creation and marketing chapter at G100. What are your goals and strategies for empowering women in Africa?
Well, basically, I'm very happy to be part of the G100 brand creation and marketing chapter. I was selected by the global chair, and I'm part of a group of ladies all over the globe, not only in Africa. Basically what we do, we have a vision, which is actually empower women within the marketing field. That's one. The second one is actually to help any women, any entrepreneur who is to use proper branding and proper marketing in developing their own business. Of course, we have initiatives like educational programs for, as I said, to focus on teaching the women how to unlock the power of branding and marketing in their business. We have also mentorship. I'm a strong believer in mentorship programs. I am a mentor and a mentee at the same time. I have like three mentees, although we would think I've reached a leadership level, but I think we still, all of us, need to be mentored, or we need a mentee, because at the end of the day, there are aspects of life that we don't know, aspects of work that we don't know, and we need a second view, someone who is absolutely can zoom out and help us make right. the right decisions. So this is for me very important. Mentorship programs are very important for young ladies and for youth in general, and they need and we want to help with that, as you know, G100 brand creation and marketing wing.
That's wonderful. So throughout your career, you've held various leadership positions in the field of market research and analytics. What unique challenges have you faced as a female leader in this particular industry, and how have you overcome them?
Well, basically, there were so many challenges. The first one I would talk about is stereotyping. You know, we usually think, women don't have that scientific mind for doing market research, and it's data, and it wasn't right. the quantity part of it. So people would think, would I be able to be a good researcher, and they would be able to analyze data and all that? And would I be able also to manage a large research team, which is mainly constituted of men, because in our domain, it was for a long time a men domain. So, and even in leadership at the time when I started, going up the ladder, we couldn't find so many women. And I actually remember, I still have a photo in my living room where we were on a board meeting in Dubai, board and senior level meeting, and there was only three women out of like 60 people on that meeting. So it was like, we were so little, and that's one of the key challenges I have, had to surpass. Another one, which is very important and very close to my heart, is the how we can, balance between family and work life. As a regional manager, I had a big region and I had to travel around the countries. Mm-hmm. So it's cool to be in planes. It's cool to be, in meetings with board members. We used to present to CEOs of big companies. That's all that is cool. Yeah. But what's not cool is that we had to miss sometimes birthdays of our kids. We had to miss school shows. And, I still remember the day when I couldn't be there on my son's school show in his first year in elementary. And that hit me, I still feel it that strong on me. Right. But thanks God, I had parents and my husband were there, and they were supporting me. When I'm not there, they are taking care of the kids, and my husband was there for his kids as well.
That's so wonderful. Not everyone gets that, so you're a lucky woman. In your opinion, what are the key qualities and skills that women bring to leadership roles, and how do these qualities contribute to the success of businesses and organizations in general?
Well, I think women bring a lot to the table of leadership. They bring a lot, first of all, our emotional intelligence and empathy. We don't just see people, we feel them. So even with our teams, with our clients, we are different in a way we work with the people. So it's beyond, you know, just listening to them. We try to understand the feeling they have, and we try to work with that as women. A second one, which I think is also important that women brings into the table, is that we pay also attention to details. And when I say details, and of course in market research, details is important because we work with numbers and percentages, but not only that, because I'm on a business of service, so we are servicing clients. It's very important to pay attention to small details that men usually won't pay attention to, like what type of coffee your client likes. Is the AC temperature good enough for the client? Is he comfortable? Is the team comfortable? This client prefers that we do this focus group in this focus room and not that one. And these small things, put his coffee, bring him, his little sweets that he loves. You remember what he ate last time, so that you bring him the same thing. So these small details are very important because it's not only about delivering. It's also about the experience the client will live with you. So if the client comes and he feels welcome, and he feels like we care about him as a person, not only as a company, because at the end of the day, no matter which business we're in, we're not in B2B, we're not in B2C, we're not in C2C, we're in a human to human. And this kind of, attentions and this kind of empathy and emotional intelligence we have towards human is very important.
Very true.
Another one, another key element or key competence that women will bring to the table and brings to the table is collaboration. We women love to collaborate. We work on teams. We work together. We don't compete. We are there to reach together that goal. And I think women in leadership brings that a lot to the table of company, and businesses have to gain, will gain a lot if we have more women in leadership.
Absolutely. That is the actual crux of the matter. We need more women in leadership.
Exactly.
So how do you envision the future of women in leadership? That's my next question. How do you envision the future of women in leadership, particularly in your industry? And what changes or advancements do you hope to see in the coming years to further promote gender diversity and equality at the top levels of leadership?
Well, basically, I think we will see more women, definitely, with all these actions around, with people, all these mentorships and all these organizations that working with women, by women, done by women, to push the women up and to break that glass of ceiling, that's glass ceiling that we all hit at a certain moment. I think, and I wish we will see more women in leadership. I think today, how I can imagine the future of leadership for women, it will be, we will have more and more tech-savvy women today. We are more open to let women go, as you said earlier, into scientific fields, into being more tech. We don't need to put them only on a, on a small square of, being artistic, or we can have tech savvy women in the future. I think we're going to smash that ceiling. We're going to smash that glass ceiling. We're going to be able to make it to the top, and we're going to be able to be as equal as men in the big corporates.
Yes, we are. Okay, well, wonderful. Thank you so much. It was great talking to you, Siham. And I hope to have more of these conversations with you in the future.
Thank you. I was very happy to have this conversation with you, Amra, and I'm looking forward to having more and more conversations with you because it's a pleasure.
And guys, if you enjoyed the interview with Siham, please make sure to give us a thumbs up. And I hope you will consider subscribing to our channel. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.